Welcome back to Couch Collectibles. Today we are looking at some 1964 Lincoln pennies that are worth money. Which ones are actually not worth money also, we're gonna look at those and other coin prices. So let's just hop right into it, but real quick, don't forget to go check out couchcollectibles.com. We have coin scales, coin microscopes, and other coin collecting supplies on the store, so be sure to go check that out. Link is always in the description of every single video. Let's just hop right into it and start off first with the fairly expensive coin. This is a 1964 penny, looks pretty normal from a distance. However, it was struck on a 1951 wheat penny. So that is really interesting, huh? It's graded at about uncirculated 58. And you can see here that the coin has the word Liberty and the 1951 date there to the right and left of Lincoln's head. So that is really cool to have that design there. And here on the reverse, you can't really make out much of the other penny design. So very awesome type of error. This penny sold for over $1,800. You cannot find these types of pennies, guys, unless you actually search for them. So make sure you guys are inspecting your coins very, very closely. Like I say, use that coin microscope. I'm about to go to the bank and get me a box of pennies myself and see if I can find me some error coins as well. Now, here is a question that I get all the time. This is on the 1964 penny, but it's also on other dated pennies as well. But you can see that there's an outline of Kennedy's head, a little miniature Kennedy there with Lincoln on the coin. So Lincoln, Kennedy, sometimes they call them the Lincoln Kennedy penny, I don't know. But these coins are not valuable. They're only worth, you know, maybe a couple dollars, if that, maybe a dollar. But they are not valuable. These are not mint errors. They were purposely struck on there by a company as to make the coin as a novelty piece. So let's move on to, again, another expensive coin. This is a 1964 Lincoln penny that was struck over a 1963 Denver minted Lincoln penny. So you can really see it here in this image. You can see the reverse design of the penny here on the front of the coin, the obverse of the penny. So that is really incredible. This is the type of error that I would love to find when I'm coin roll hunting pennies. Now, here on the reverse, again, you can see the design of Lincoln's head. So that is really cool as well. And this coin here sold for a whopping $4,000. It actually sold for over $4,000. So that is a really awesome type of error to always look for. Now, here is a 1964. Now, this coin is only valuable because of its high grade of a mint state 67. So it's got that mint state 67 red grade, and that's why the coin is valuable. Doesn't have any types of errors. This coin sold for over $7,900, so nearly a $8,000 penny. But let's move on to some more coins. Now, this coin here looks like it was struck through some type of cloth. It sold on eBay for around $250, and that's what it was. It was graded by Annex, and it was struck through cloth. So that is really cool. Like I said, $250 coin. Now here's just a $5 coin. It sold on eBay. You can see it's not in the best condition, not in the worst condition by any means, but it's just got a little minor clip there, clipped planchet there at the bottom of the coin. So that coin, $5 coin, nothing too crazy. Now if we look at a 1964D, again, this is solely valuable because of its high grade of a mint state 67, just like the no mint mark that we looked at. And this coin sold for over $4,000 because of its high grade. Now here's another coin that sold on eBay, the 1964 off-center penny, and it's really struck pretty good off-center there. And this coin sold for around $30. So 30 bucks, can't beat it for a penny, but I would personally keep it in my coin collection for 30 bucks. Now here's something to look for on your 1964 pennies. If we zoom into that D mint mark, you can see how it looks like it's doubled. That is a repunched mint mark. So it's a RPM repunched mint mark. You can look for that with your coin microscopes, again, which I have available on couchcollectibles.com. Now here's the coin that has that repunched mint mark. It only sold for around 10 bucks, but I would definitely still always be on the lookout for those RPMs on your coins, because some of them could really add some value to your coins depending on which coin it actually is on. Now here's a 1964 that was struck through some type of staple or some type of wire, which we can see here on the right side of the coin. And this coin sold for around $70 on eBay. If we look at a 1964 penny that was double struck, this coin here sold on eBay for over $90, so nearly a $100 penny. Also, on your 1964 pennies, don't forget to look for a double die reverse. So doubling taking place on the lettering of the coin here on E Pluribus Unum, that phrase, always be on the lookout for that. You can really see that double die taking place. That can always add value to your coins. Now here's another coin that sold on eBay. You can see that it has been struck through a capped die. The coin only sold for around $20. I would personally keep it and keep it in my coin collection for 20 bucks. But here is another 1964 Lincoln penny that has been struck on a dime planchet. So a Roosevelt dime. So you can see that it is being cut off, the phrasing God We Trust, the date 1964 being cut off there. And then here on the reverse, United States of America slightly being cut off there and touching the bottom of 1 cent. And that's a result of the error. But this is a very expensive coin. This coin sold for over $4,800. So always weigh your coins, inspect them closely for different types of errors like these. Here's another error coin from 1964. This coin has been triple struck, and you can see that it's pretty self-explanatory type of mint error taking place here. And this coin sold for around $1,100. So $1,100. Here's a 1964 again. This is a die cap error taking place. This is a deep die cap, as it says here on the coin slab, by PCGS, graded at a mint state 66 red. And this coin is really, really awesome, man. This coin sold for over $1,100 as well, $1,100. Man, that is just an awesome type of die cap there. That is pretty awesome. I would love to find something like that in the coin roll. Check out these other 1960 pennies that are worth money. A 1967 stock image penny. You can see that they produced over 3 billion of these coins. So they're very, very common coins. Nothing too rare about them. But there are different things to look for. And this first image here is a clipped error. Now that's just an example of a coin. It probably sold on eBay for a few dollars. You know, it hasn't been graded, nothing like that. But if we move on to this coin is crazy. Clearly not gonna find something like this in a coin roll, as it wouldn't fit in a coin roll. This is a 1967 that has been triple struck, with the second and third strikes being off center, and it is graded by Annex. And this coin sold on eBay for over $900. Now here is a capped die. Now if you go to the bank, you get a box of penny rolls, you search through penny rolls, you can find all kinds of different stuff. Now you're not gonna find this every single day, but I have found a capped die penny, believe it or not, in a penny roll, and I about freaked out. But this one here is a 1967 that has that capped die. And it sold for over $25. It hasn't been graded or anything like that. So it's a $25 penny that you find, you know, in your pocket change or when you're coin roll hunting pennies. So definitely a good profit. Now, of course, you can always look for off centers on any type of coin. Here is a 1967. And this penny here sold on eBay for over $50. Now here is a 1967 special mint set penny, so an SMS. Now it is graded at a mint state 68, so it's got an extremely, extremely high grade, and that is what's gonna give it a lot of value. Now this penny here sold for over $5,500. Moving on to another 1967 penny. This is graded by PCGS at a mint state 67. So again, an extremely high graded coin, as the coin grading scale only goes up to 70. If you haven't seen my coin grading videos, feel free to check those out. And this penny here sold for over $2,300. All right, guys, don't forget to subscribe in the middle. Check out the videos to the left of me. And until tomorrow, I will see you all in the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.